This video is going to be all about layers and layer styles, and I'll talk about what those layer styles are. But layers in Photoshop are these individual elements. So this is one layer, and so on. These are all different layers that make up our design here in Photoshop. And the benefits of using layers like this is that you have individual control over all these elements. For example, this Instagram logo is one layer, and it's on its own independent layer. So if I press this eyeball here, I could turn it on and off, and I could individually affect this layer without affecting my entire image. So working with layers in Photoshop is my favorite thing, and it's the thing that you're really gonna spend most of your time with in Photoshop. So let me just show you a few things. The first thing is creating layers. So if you wanna create a layer from scratch, these layers were all independently created or they were brought into Photoshop. For example, this PSD, this Photoshop icon, I just brought this as a PNG file. I dragged it over and placed it here, and it created a new layer for me. So sometimes dragging an element into a Photoshop file creates a layer for you. But if you want to create one from scratch down here, you'll see this icon. And if you press it, it creates a layer. So now I have layer 17. I could just turn it on and off, and there's nothing on this layer. So this is not affecting our image. And if you want to delete a layer, just select it and press delete. So that's how you create a layer. So what can you do with layers? Well, layers could be images, like independent images like you see here, or here's another one. This is our background. So if I turn this on and off, that's that Instagram photo in the background. There could be text layers. So here's a text layer. Now, how do you create a text layer? Same thing. Just go ahead and create a new layer just like this. And if you press T for the T tool with this layer selected, and you go here and you just click somewhere in your Photoshop document, you could just start typing. And there's a text layer. See, it just created a text layer from that layer I just created. So layer 17 turned into a text layer. And with text layers, you have all the control of a text. So if I select this, I could just change everything about that text up here, just like anything else. So I'm just gonna delete that. Now here's a text layer that I've already created. And if I turn this on and off, you could see it in the middle of the screen. So that's a text layer, and an image layer looks just like this. And if you want to name a layer, you just click the text. You just double click that, and I could call this background, for example. So now that's my background layer. That's how you name a layer. And turning it on and off is just like this with this eyeball. And the next thing is organizing this layer. Right now, I have a bunch of layers, and they're not really organized, but you could actually organize them into these groups by clicking this tab down here. It creates a group. So you could just drag something like this and put it inside the group just like that. So the layer, the background, this layer. Now you see how things changed. The order of your layers matter. So the layer on top shows first. So if I bring this to the top, it shows first, and the blue one was on top of the white one here. So as you could see, the order makes a big difference. So if I put this on the bottom, it's really gonna change it. The blue is gonna show instead of this background layer. So the order makes a big difference. And by grouping them, you could turn off the entire group. So now if I turn this off, everything in the background should be gone just like that. So that's why you would do a group. Another way to create a group just like this, for example, my logo here is multiple layers. So there's the text layer, and there's another text layer, and there's the logo. There's three different layers. So I could select this. I'm gonna just shift select these three, and then I could press this group, and it'll put it in a group for me just like that. And just like everything else, I could double click this, and I could just name this what I want to. And if I turn this on and off, now all those layers could disappear. And the same thing that you would do with individual layers, you could open this up and you could turn each layer on and off just like that, or all three at the same time. So this is a great way to organize your files. Now, a lot of times you want to create something fast and you'll skip this, but I recommend organizing your files the best way you can in the layer panel. It's a lot easier than to start from a design. For example, with these images that I create for YouTube, I always come back to the same design, and then I could just double click this and then change this text. For example, I could turn this off and then put another icon there. It's really an easier way if you have it organized just like this. I know, for example, that my Howfinity logo is always going to be there, and so on. So that's a brief view of the layer panel, but let me just show you layer style, which is also a powerful tool to really customize each individual layer. So on any given layer, if you double click on the text, you could change the text. But if you double click right here on the side, it opens this panel called layer style. And with layer style, you could do a lot of different things to an individual layer. For example, I could create a drop shadow, which is a most commonly used layer styling that I use, especially for text. As you could see here, there's a drop shadow. But if you look at this Photoshop icon, I could press drop shadow. You see the difference there? It's creating a drop shadow. And if you want to individually affect that, you could select it like this, and then you could change the opacity of the drop shadow, the distance, and so on. So I'm gonna just press Command Z to undo that. And then you could change the blending mode and everything else with each individual blending option here. So let me just turn this off and let me show you bevel, for example. So if I choose bevel, as you could see, it's having the impact here. So I could on and off it like this. If I turn this off, if I wanna do stroke, I could just check that on, and then I could come here and change the stroke options. So it gives you a lot of options with this. And one of my favorite things that it does is, let me just show you this on an image. So I'm just gonna open this background group, and I'll turn this off so you can see this blue layer. I use the gradient overlay as a layer option. So if I double click this over here, if I didn't have gradient overlay, I just had a basic blue color that I created with a shape. So if I check this on now, I use the gradient overlay, and these are the options I have with gradient overlay. And I could change the opacity and so on, for example, to affect this background. So I could press OK there. And here, let me double click this one. I have multiple different layer styles. So I have gradients and inner shadow. So inner shadow, as you can see on the sides, is making it darker. Gradient overlay is just creating a gradient color overlay, and sends making everything darker so the text could pop. Now play around with layer styles, see which ones come in handy for you. I know for me, drop shadow, stroke, gradient overlay are some of the most common ones I use. Bevel from time to time. And then I play around with the setting under each individual one to really get the look that I'm going for. So that's a brief overview of layers and layer styles. It'll help you organize your Photoshop file. And it also gives you an option to edit each layer with a lot of different options in the layer style panel. I hope you found this helpful. Please give it a like and subscribe to this channel, and stay tuned for the next video. Thanks for watching.